Yo, welcome to How to Write a Novel, another episode recorded on my fancy pants new phone, which means it's going to sound a little suckier. And there's also traffic everywhere, but there's nothing I can do about that. So, I'm at this Airbnb that I stayed at last year, and I kind of didn't really like it because I'm on the outskirts of Toronto, sort of near Scarborough Town Center. A little west of there. And it is just trafficsville, man. I mean, Toronto's all about traffic anyway. Very big car culture out here. Not pedestrian friendly. But especially out here, it's absurd. Every street is just a major thoroughfare. Kind of sucks. So we get some nice traffic noise for this episode. But yeah, it's a weird thing though. Even though I was out here for a month last summer and, you know, just because of the traffic, didn't have a great time, but I decided to book it for a couple of weeks again this year because, I don't know, it's weird. I just have little memories like this one coffee shop near here I read Treasure Island at. And I don't know, there's just something about going back to a place that I've been to before. Even though it was only for a month, it kind of feels like my neighborhood. It's like, oh, I'll go back to the old neighborhood. But now that I'm here, I'm like, oh yeah, the old neighborhood sucked fucking balls. And the nice little coffee shop where I read Treasure Island is closed. And even if I wanted to go corporate, the Starbucks, the nice little Starbucks where I did a bunch of work last summer, is also closed. So now I'm stuck out here in Trafficville with nowhere to go. All the nice little coffee shops I was planning on hanging out at don't exist anymore. So yeah, this was kind of a sucky day because, I don't know, I just walked from fucking Kennedy over to Warden, down to Ellesmere. All I did all day was walk around traffic because there's no way to escape it. I just went to like Tim Hortons, that's all I could find. But yeah, I spent most of the day just editing audio. Got a bunch of different podcasts and stuff I'm working on. I guess a combination of editing audio and I'm trying to read through all my books before I leave Toronto because I don't want to travel with books. So, you know, the day just kind of slipped away. I was doing stuff all day, but not writing. And really the only point of this little podcast, the only thing that was on my mind is just that it really is worth it to force yourself over that hump where the sun went down. I'm still a little ways from my Airbnb, but I could just go back. And I was about to, I was like, oh, I didn't do any writing today, but I don't know, man, whatever. Like, you know, you can make an excuse out of anything. So I'm just like, I mean, there's just so much traffic around here. And that coffee shop I was going to go to is not here anymore. Like, you know, if you're looking for an excuse, anything will do. To me, that really felt like enough of an excuse. Like, oh, I don't know, the writing gods would understand that, right? No one could argue that. I had a slightly noisy day, and I had to go to a boring Tim Hortons instead of the cool coffee shop that I wanted to go to. Like, just ridiculous, just dumb. But I said, no! I said, fuck that! That's the one nice thing about industrial neighborhoods where it's just like big highways everywhere. You can be as loud as you want. It's the next best thing to just being completely alone in the woods. As far as if you just want to sing to yourself or you just want to yell inappropriately, it's good for that. Because no one else is here. Why would they be? There's a highway crossing another highway, and around me is all just like loading docks and stuff. Why am I here? Why would anyone on foot be here? I definitely got this out of my system. I cannot imagine next time I'm in Toronto coming back to this neighborhood. It wasn't cheap either. It's not like it was cheaper. Like a nice inexpensive Airbnb is the same as everywhere else. It's the same as being by the beaches. Anyway, the point is, I went to a Tim Hortons, got a coffee, hunkered down. It's like, come on, fuckface. I'm not asking that much of you. You don't have to work hard. You don't have to do very much, but you have to do something. You have to. We might only sit here for 20 minutes. That's fine. But you have to do that. Like, I'm not a fan of pushing oneself excessively. I think in the long term, that's a bad idea because it just makes you hate writing and it makes the idea of writing not fun. And I think the ideas that come out of it are less inspired and just don't feel fresh and don't feel good if you're just pushing yourself and forcing yourself into a productivity that just isn't there. But I think it is important and it is valuable and it is worthwhile to push yourself just to do something, to not let the day slip away. I mean, in a way, working every day is just an arbitrary decision. I mean, it could be every week, it could be whatever, you could pick any time frame. But every day just makes sense because of the planet we're on and the creatures we are. Every night you go to bed, every day you get up and do stuff. Every day is just the easiest, best delineation. You're never confused about, when was the last time I did some writing? Did I hit my quota? If it was, say, every week, it's like, did I do it this week yet? You know, it's just, every day is just way easier, way more applicable to the creatures we are and the life we live. And it really makes all the difference, because on the one side, the writing every day builds up, but on the other side, say I skipped today, say I hadn't sat down and done some writing today, then it's like I'm just in a different mindset. I'm going into an underpass, gonna get some echoes. Oh, that's a nightmare. Fucking traffic. But yeah, if I hadn't had written today, then maybe tomorrow I'm like, yeah, well, I missed yesterday too. Maybe it's just time to take a little break. Maybe I should just, you know, relax. Maybe I should let myself take a little vacation. Maybe I should just take the week off. Like, as soon as you allow that first step to happen, it's so much easier. It's so easy for that to take hold. It's so easy for that one little break in the orthodoxy, that one little failure to observe your little writing ceremony of writing every day. And one day turns into 2 days, and 2 days turns into 2 weeks, and 2 weeks turns into 2 years. And that's what, as I've been saying throughout this podcast, that's what has been happening to me since I was fucking 19 years old. That's what's been happening for 20 years. That's why I didn't get anything done for decades. I just write and write and write and write, and I've got reams and reams of stuff, but nothing ever gets finished because there needs to be some basic level of dedication, some basic level of discipline. And without that, you got nothing. You got nothing, son. So I'm also at an awkward spot. I'm working on three little stories. I got my major novel, but two other little things. And I'm at an awkward spot in two of them. Like, I'm at the start of a new chapter where I'm really not quite sure what's supposed to happen next. So I've been digging through notes and trying to determine where things are going to go in this next chapter. And it's a very unexciting kind of anxious, anxiety-inducing, sort of stressful. Just that, like, leaping out of the nest and hoping that you fly feeling of, like, I really am not clear on what the next stage is. In two stories at once. It just timed out bad that way. So that's mostly all I did today, is I went through the notes I had gathered and I arranged them in a generalized order. Like, probably this note can lead to that note, can lead to that note, can lead to that note, can lead to the end of the chapter. And then as I write, that could shift and change and other stuff could happen. But mostly that's all I did today, is arrange a guideline, some kind of rough guidepost for the next week or two of work on these chapters. But I feel so much better about this whole day. this whole day that kind of sucked, and if I had just gone home, it would continue to suck, and I would have to fend away the little guilt in the back of my mind that was like, you know you didn't write today. You know you skipped out on it for no good reason. Now it's the exact opposite, where I'm like, oh man, like I really did only sit there for 20 minutes. I didn't do that much, but I arranged things for tomorrow. I feel much more confident about where things are going tomorrow. And I didn't break the chain. I stayed orthodox, you know? I stayed walking the righteous path. Like I said, like last time, all you gotta do to be a writer is write. As long as there's more done at the end of the day than there was at the start, that's it. You are a writer. You can call yourself a writer. You can think of yourself as a writer with no guilt and no explanation and no like, oh, you know, I'd like to be a writer, but I'm not really. No, if you write every day, you're a writer. That's it. That's all you gotta do. And that's all I did today. But that's all that it takes. So that's all this episode is. Almost a real shit day. But because I stuck to the plan, I stuck to the daily grind. I didn't skip it. I didn't do much, but I did more than nothing. And that's all it takes. And it turned this whole day around. And if nothing else, this is like a reminder to myself, you know? Next time I'm trying to justify, like, nah, I can skip today, right? Again, it's so dumb when you say it out loud. Oh, the coffee shop I wanted wasn't open. I mean, once you're in the throes of writing, you're in another world. It doesn't matter what seat I'm sitting in. It doesn't matter what table I'm at. It doesn't matter that it's a slightly different brand of coffee. It is like a 1% difference that once you're in the throes of writing becomes a 0% difference because I'm not even there. I'm just in my own head. Ridiculous that I was trying to get away with that. Come on, brain. Come on, subconscious. Fuck you. I didn't give in and I will never give in. I ain't never scared. What song should I play? All right, that's the episode for today. Thanks for listening. For the song, let's listen to Anti Up by M.O.P. Because this is just a classic hip-hop tune about, I don't know, antiing up. I don't know that it's applicable at all. It's just an awesome song. I haven't heard it in a while. So, yeah, I'll see you next time. Thank you for listening. Give me the fuck.